Hey guys, it's Kevin. Just a quick video show you how to plug in the Colorsun. This is a printer override board, breakout board, or whatever you call it, driver board. What else? There are a whole bunch of names. One thing before I start is, see, this is the plug, okay? See a little like a nipple on top, okay, sort of a line. When you plug in the base, and this is the base that sits on the PCB board. So this goes through the board. When it sits there, that notch is here, okay? So that thing fits right into this groove, okay? So this is what I mean, the notch side is up and down. This is important, is because Colorsun glued this whole thing together to the board. So when you pull it, you pull off the base and the plug, okay? And so for example, this one, you're going to see what I write on the connection sheet is the notch side is where the side of the notch, just in case you did not pull off the thing with the glue. Okay, let me show you.
So where the file is, bchtechnologies.com, and search for 3090 diagram. And this diagram for DTF Pro Model J, that's not yours. Oh, I'm showing you how to get a connection diagram, which goes with this video. I'm not selling any board. We do not sell Colorsun board. And this diagram for 3090, and it said look exactly like this board, and that's not yours either. And this one said 3090C6655 main board, Colorsun board as in picture. Click on it, and that tell you the board look exactly like in the picture, second picture. And yes, this is the board you want. And in this file, for example, this purple one, I told you the notch side is down and the glue side is up. So if you find your notch and the notch side should be down, and you cannot find a notch which the whole thing glued together, the glue side is up, okay? Or by up this way. So basically they put the board on, then they just drop two drop of glue on it. So that's why the glue side always up. And for everything else, I just refer to that the diagram on the side. This one is connect to the forward, the roll forward and backwards button. I received lots of repairs that doesn't have this one attached to anything. So I feel it's weird that you have a printer, but you're not used the whole function. But basically, if you have a printer that's for sheet feeding, but have this one, you can just extend it, this one, put a connection on it, and then you have a roll feed printer. So this one, lots of you do not have this plug-in, okay? Is to the 24 volt power. So if you trace all the way here, and this is a power converter, okay? So see the L and N, those two are from your wall. So those L and N are 110 volts. So if you put your finger on there, and you're going to see the doctor, okay? Or maybe you'll not see the doctor because you already passed out. This the main power can't fit in those L and N and the ground. And then it split, one side split to the printer. Power supply supply the main board. That's why lots of you have a main board breakdown. And you say, oh, my printer's still working because this one split. And here's the control. This control controls the temperature thing, and eventually you can rewire this to control the mixer. If you're interested, you can modify the control the mixer too. So that's why you can turn the printer on and that part is working, and this part totally doesn't work. Okay, the black will go to the ground, and see the 24 volts. The red line will go to that 24 volts. And this is called ASF motor. And some of you just mistaken this motor plug-in
and plug in here. Don't do that, okay? Refer to the diagram. And everything else should be pretty straightforward. This is a CR motor. And this CR motor goes to the main board. The main board is color to color. Okay, you can see white plug will have a white base and the black plug will have a black base. Okay, you cannot go wrong with it. And from your cartridge return, you should have a CRPW cable. And then you're going to have three printhead cable. Okay, CRPW cable. Okay, see it's from, you can see it go all the way from the printhead, goes up there and comes out to the CRPW. And this is called APG, and this board right here is called a subboard, or we call it a relay board. The relay board is going to come out with as a white cable or FFC, goes here, and here it goes to the main board. Okay. And what else? Okay, and that's a page feed motor. Page feed motor goes in here and comes out from here and goes to the main board. And those two blue ones are not used. Already said this cover. This is the power, and this is the control. Oh, this the CSIC from the CSIC is the cartridge board. So come out, supposed to go to the cartridge return on the OEM printer, but this one is modified. So the CSIC cable goes into this one, overrides your cartridge. So it pretend to be a cartridge. So whenever you have cartridge problem, you just press this button. And that one is the control board, control panel. Control panel goes in here. In the middle. Okay.
I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.